Well, summer is coming a bit early this year. Well, it's going to be amazing on Tuesday. The summer is. So what do I decide to do? Let's make carbon roof. So this is the scope we are working with, right? It's a fairly large roof. By my calculations, it's 1.65 square meters. There's a few problematic bits and pieces. As you've seen in the beginning, we already removed the windscreen and woohoo! Came out in one piece. I don't sound very excited, but I am very excited because that's another couple of £100 I didn't want to spend on a new heated windscreen. So the idea is to make a mold. Yes, this time I'm making a proper mold because I want to replicate it and make a few of them for people if they want to buy one. Mind you, I'm just gonna say right now, it's not going to be a short car roof. It's going to be a race car roof. So it's not going to be absolutely perfect because A, I don't have the facilities to do the pre-preg and autoclave thing. So it will be hand laminated. It would still look good, but I highly suggest watch this video till the end and decide if this is the kind of quality for you, because I'm not gonna get people, you know, buy a roof and be like, oh, it's not perfect, you have a pinhole here and there. Yes, I know it is. It's a DIY, so it's not going to be as expensive as a professional company, but it will still be fairly expensive material alone just for this. Yeah, anyways, there's two problematic spots. One being here, the channel, because in here, the original one has a rubber. We need to retain it because obviously the air coming in and out and most, yeah. So the idea is, when you replace this windscreen, the roof, you will retain the original gutter from the old car. So you'll cut it like that, right at the on the edge, and the original, where you take it off, the spot welds, you'll be able to literally just spot weld it back into place. And then the new carbon roof literally will overlap on that with the sealant. That way you retain this lip, metal lip, for the sealer, and the roof can go on. Another problematic bit is here, this gutter. I think I don't want to use the infill piece for a few reasons. One, extra weight. Why do you need extra pieces? And B is just a bit more complicated to replicate those little pins that hold it. It needs to be sort of the correct distances and heights and stuff like that. And it's just not worth it. So what I'm thinking of doing is smoothing this over with clay or wax. So when we lay the new one, it will literally come all the way to the edge with a little lip on the inside. So when you apply the sealant, it will literally cover this area and it will come right to the edge of this. Also, there is another, I haven't taken this off yet. There is an indent in there, but I'm sure we'll be able to work around it. The biggest issue I see is because of lip on here, on the underneath and on the back. The releasing this mold might be a little problematic. But we never know until we try. We're not gonna find out. So the front bit, pretty self-explanatory. We're gonna make a little flange so we have extra material, and it's just spot welds. So the original, the new one will have literally the same lip, so it will go into the same position. So you can just use special sealant. There's a number of them on the market. The one I am gonna use, and I've been using for all my other stuff, you can buy from Easy Composites. It's the PU18. Polyurethane sealant and adhesive. Very strong, very versatile, fairly cheap, does the job. All right, remove this. Then we need to remove all the stickers. We also need to remove our Clubman Motorsport sticker. Rob was upset that I removed that sticker when I fitted his extinguisher system onto the back. He was like, oh, do I need to send you more stickers? Little did he know that I actually had two stickers. One was always on the roof. So it's okay, Rob, I have a few of them. By the way, Clubman Motorsport, link is in the description. All of your extinguisher and seats and harnesses needs and stuff like that, they have it. Very fast service. remove the stickers, and today I can properly prep it. I will go to town on wax and on PVA, so we know 100% that we can release this mold. And tomorrow, when all the materials get here, we're gonna make mold.
Tomorrow.
Day. No wonder why carbon fiber parts cost an absolute fortune. Just to prepare this roof for mold, taking me pretty much all day. Yes, maybe I work slow. Yes, maybe I've done a few things wrong, but who cares? Anyways, very happy how it looks. The mold. Well, the plug for the mold. Anyways, a flange for the windscreen so we don't have any spillage, so we get a nice little bit and pieces. It will be trimmed on here after it's done. Then we have wax everywhere in here in the corners, so it releases better, so that's very good. Here, as you can see, I've removed those little pits and dots. I mean, let's be honest, am I ever gonna use it as a roof rack attaching apparatus? Probably not. So yeah, so they're gone and they're not coming back, and then those trim pieces will be just glued in place on the rear, because the mold will go all the way to the back. We have a little barrier, and then it will be trimmed right here on the corner. All the holes are filled with a bit of wax and everything. This in particular, ideally you obviously want to fill it with fill and then sand it and paint it. We're not doing that. We're just putting a special tape, and then when the mold is ready, I'll just wet and dry it, smooth it over, so you don't actually see it on the final part. Same on the other side. Everything is covered, because obviously we don't want any spillages of resin on top of the car. I applied 3 coats of wax. This is a third one, slightly still wet, needs another 10 minutes before it kind of dries off slightly, and then we just buff it off, and then maybe we'll apply one more coat of wax. And actually, I don't think I will be applying PVA this time, because I've been reading about it in Easy Composites. They actually say that you don't need to apply PVA. I mean, you can too, but what it does, and actually I found what it does, it started beading. So you don't actually get a film of PVA on top of whatever mold. So on the final thing, you'll just end up seeing those streaks, and we don't want that. They're basically saying that if you apply PVA on top of your wax and it doesn't do that, and it's just a nice clear coat, then you haven't done the waxing correct. So 3-4 layers of wax buffed and the correct procedure should be absolutely enough for this one. So fingers crossed. Well, it looks like we've reached the B stage. B stage means it's still tacky, but nothing comes onto your glove. So at this stage, we are ready to apply the first layer of reinforcement. We're using 300 gram. Sort of a lightweight reinforcement, obviously just fiberglass, one layer, and then again we have to wait until the B stage, and then we apply 450 grams, 4 layers of that with more resin. It's going to be difficult to work by myself, but lockdown, can't get any help. Yeah, we have a mold. It's been overnight and it looks like, well, to be fair, this thing was drying out really, really quick. By the time I would move to a next half, this one would already be setting and getting off heat and stuff like that. So shall we try and demold it? Let's go. Probably say, what was the point of a time lapse? In all honesty, I was expecting it to take a little bit longer as well. That's why I was like, let's get a time lapse so people can see how I demold it. Nah, literally, pry bar at the top under those little corners, put a wedge in there, and then just start lifting it, and like, boom, off we went under 1 minute. Perfect. Very happy with that. So we've done our job right with wax and PVA. The surface is really good. I'm very, very happy and surprised. Well, not surprised, but happy. And all the corners is exactly how we want it to be. Exactly how we want it to be. Everything is absolutely spot on. So I really don't see a problem making a new one from carbon now. The only other issue, and I think I talked about it before, is the slip. So whoever is gonna want to have one. Anyways, watch this video until the end. I'll most likely show you how I fit mine. So let's take all of this crap off, clean it all up, give it a quick wash because PVA has a thin film on it and it's water soluble, like I said before. Brilliant stuff from Easy Composites. Wash it, maybe wet sand it. I don't know, maybe wet sand it. Although this number 22 that used to be on my bonnet it appears. So most likely I'll just wet sand it just to bring it to even better condition, better shine. And then we need to measure up how much carbon Kevlar we have. Because in all honesty, like I said, I wasn't planning to do it this soon. I was planning to do it maybe in June, July, closer to summer because of the weather, but we were blessed yesterday with a scorching 24 degree summer day, probably the only one day this year. And yeah, we have a mold. So now, naturally, because the windscreen is out, so I have to make this today, tomorrow, or something like that, and we can fit it all, put the windscreen back in, and like nothing ever happened. So